So I'm Christine Magick, and I'm from Paris. My mom is half Caribbean, half Vietnamese, and my dad is Chinese Cambodian. I've been born and raised in France, in between France and Vietnam. I come from a background where it was very Buddhist, very vipassana, silent. In the same time, my education was towards hip-hop, towards music, and I had so much love for music that I learned English very fast to know the lyrics, to understand what people were transmitting in their lyrics and songs. So basically, I unfold my journey, work as a diplomat, and then I woke up and I went into a movement journey. So I started to practice Kung Fu, Shaolin Kung Fu. So I went to China and trained with the monks in and out for about 10 years. And in this following my dreams, because I follow my parents' dreams to have a master's degree in political science. And then when I reached that, I was like, yeah, okay, I'm there. It's not fulfilling me. There was something missing. And the missing part was my inner child. What I wanted when I was a young child, I wanted to be a Kung Fu Shaolin kid. I wanted to dance, I wanted to sing, I wanted to be in nature, but I could not because my parents are refugees and they wanted me to be safe, to be secure with a good work. So I just followed the education, the left brain, and I had no chance to express my creativity, my creative juice. And all my friends are artists. So I was kind of like a shadow artist, like enjoying my friends dancing, rapping, doing all kinds of arts. And I was always, I wish I could. So when I reached that state of, I can. Actually, you know what? I'm going to China and I'm going to train the monks. So I went to China back in 2010 and it shifted my whole life. Because I lived in Asia for a couple of years and then my dream was to be in New York, be in the city of my love, hip-hop, soul, the culture. But then I added martial arts, Qigong, spirituality. Spirituality was always in the background. But then I went to New York and the dream just failed. I was so depleted, so sad. I was like, actually, I wanted to be in New York all these 10 years and work my ass off, can I say that? to have a master's degree and then I can work for the UN, and it did not happen because I connected with martial arts, so I wanted to go to China and train. And then moving forward, I added meditation, I added Reiki, I added yoga. From that time, all my travels were dedicated to my spiritual expansion. So I added Capoeira, I love movement, so I'm a mover. My medicine is movement, my medicine is breath, and the new journey I'm in is plant medicine. So I love plants, I love flowers, and I've been working with them since I came to Bali. And
let's talk about how all of your practices and passions throughout your journey to this point of enlightenment, how have they intersected here in Bali?
How they were accepted?
Intersected.
Yeah. Oh.
How do they connect or mesh or interlink? You know, there's this intra connectivity happening throughout your entire life, it sounds like, right?
Yeah.
How has Bali been a safe place for all of that to take place?
Oh my God. So the first thing is when I came to Bali, it was for yoga teacher training the second time. So I said to myself, oh, I'm going to be a yoga teacher. This is something that I can combine.
Again, accomplishing something, targeting something, wanting to do it, doing it.
Exactly.
Taking action.
I always took action, but follow my heart because this is what I wanted to do. And this is what I felt like I would be in service. In service to others, but but also can combine money at the same time. So I came here, I finished, and I wasn't complete. Because, I'm going to go a little bit deep. I was a sexual abuse kid as a child. So I was not in my body fully. So the movement practice got me into the body, but I searched something to protect me, martial arts. But then I came to Bali, Mama Bali told me, no, you're gonna experiment the feminine energy, the water, the land, the elements. So I kind of like shift to Capoeira a little bit more. So there was circular movement, there was dancing, there was play. But when COVID happened, my body just collapsed for all the practices that I've been doing. And I couldn't have like normal pain that I always had, but it was like cosmic slap. No, you're not gonna be able to do that anymore. So I shifted to dance. So I went back to my roots, my Caribbean roots, and I've been doing Afro-Caribbean dance, but Afro beats dance too, to unlock those hips, because the trauma I had was the first chakra, the safety to Mother Earth, the survival mode. So Bali has been a container for me to actually fully come back into my body and be present with it and enjoy the movement in a different way, with more grace, more sensuality, and healing. And of course, healing was in the mix, but here I develop more a sense of being a channel, receiving, connecting to that source energy in my body, and just know that I am safe, that this is my gift. Because when you do that, gifts are unfolding from the ancestors, new gifts unfolding because you release your trauma, because you work on your self-development, self-healing. So many things are coming into place through meditation, through breathing, through moving with intention. So there's always an intention, but after you have to let it flow, you have to surrender and you have to be receptive. There's many layers, but the layers I've been experimenting here is really receptivity. Listen to the ancestors, listen to the fairies, listen to the divine in others, in the plants, in the elements. Everything is a teaching.
And do you believe that Tounché is supporting those notions or those points of enlightenment and these elements of, these foundational elements of our divine connection?
Yes, definitely. Tounché is a big container of different elements, different people who has been gone through their journey authentically and come to share with their heart what feels good for them. And in what feels good for them is the notion of our ancestors, the land. And when I talk about ancestors, it's like ancestors from different parts of the world. And they have that in their DNA. And sometimes I know it could be problematic and an issue. Some people dive into things that are not belong to their ancestors. So there are like some kind of like, I know in this world, especially spirituality, there's appropriation. This thing is recurrent, but I know that it's really, really healing when it's someone from that ancestry share their knowledge from their parents, from their ancestors, from their land. And I think Tounché is a big container for this diversity, because we also don't want to dwell in the traumas. We want to go beyond. We want reconciliation. you want to bring something, and everyone is here to bring something. It doesn't matter what you bring, is to come together with what you come here to express freely, without limitation, I would say. And it can be anything. And we have all the power of it, we have all the function. It doesn't matter at the end of the day. It's just like sharing, being embodied in what we share, like not only doing in our corner at home and then we go out and we forget about what we receive, but giving as much as we receive and play with the densities, the polarities. And if you've never been to Bali, Bali is a playground, a light and a dark, your shadow and your light. So even if you don't want to do some work, you will face with situation, dynamics, relationships. I always say that one relationship in Bali equals one lifetime. And it's really potent energy here because people have been cultivating this devotion to God, to the universe, to the divine, and they're in their heart as much as they can. They believe in the universal laws. That's why this land is welcoming us with such openness, with diverse background, diverse spirituality. This is part of our growth. You will see that all religion, all philosophy has positive in it, different angles, and if we bring everything together, it makes whole, because not one religion or one philosophy has everything in it.
That's correct.
That's an illusion.
It's true.
That's why mixed people is good, because it's bringing all this culture all together, and even if you're not mixed bloodly, but you've been traveling, you're mixed. You won't see the world as you see, because you've been to Japan, and you've been to Africa, and you've been in the desert of Mongolia, South America. You're not the same. That's the beauty of Tounché, that blend.
Awesome. Mr. Magick, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thank you for taking time out.